Hello, Lindsay here from Equator. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a 3D terrain in Revit using a .dwg or AutoCAD file. So first thing, we want to source our contour data or our topographic data. And we can do that in Equator. So we want to open Equator, either log in or create a new account, and then we can either search for our site by using the search bar, or we can just zoom into the area that we need to go to. Okay. Zoom into this area right here. Then we want to go to the data tab and we want to turn on elevation data just to make sure that the site we have chosen actually has LiDAR coverage. And it looks like it does have LiDAR coverage. So now we want to create a new site by selecting the new site button down here. Okay, we will zoom in to our designated area. We can change the site boundary if we would like to, but for this purpose, we will just select, okay, this is an okay boundary for our project. Now we want to go to, again, the data tab, and the second option is contours as a DWG. So select the plus symbol. We would like it for site one, that's the site we've just created. Select site one, the highest quality, and then we can choose if we want smooth or detailed. For this project, I will select detailed, which gives us a contour interval of 0.3 meters. Hit generate, and it is currently processing. We can see that by the green bar down here. And there we are. These are our contour lines here. So now we want to download those by hitting that download button. We would like to export it to a DWG file. In this coordinate system, that's fine for our project. If you need to download in a different coordinate system, then you can choose custom and enter the coordinate system that you need to use. We're going to use match the project, so meter for vertical unit, and select process. Okay, so our files are now downloaded. If we go to our download folder, we have two files that were just downloaded, a README file, which shows all of our metadata, and then a zipped file, which will contain our DWG file. So let's just extract that. Okay, and let's check what's in that folder. And so you have a couple different files that get downloaded with that, but what we are really interested in is this .dwg file. So now we want to go into Revit. We open Revit and we say new model. You probably have a template that you use for your work. For my case, I'm just going to select none. Okay. And then metric, because we've downloaded our CAD file in metric units. First step is bringing our CAD drawing in. So we can either link our CAD drawing or import our CAD drawing. If our CAD drawing may change in the future, then we should link it and then we can easily upload the new changes. If you have no changes that are going to be made in the future to that CAD drawing, then you can just import it. But for this presentation, this demonstration, I am going to link the CAD drawing. We want to navigate to where our CAD drawing is. So in this case, it's in my downloads file. Select contour. Now we want to make sure the current view only is turned off. This ensures that we can see it in 3D, that the X, Y, and Z are there. And then I changed my import units to meters because that is what we downloaded our .dwg file in. And then the rest should be okay. Open. Okay, and here is our CAD drawing. So if we go into our 3D view, we can see that it is indeed 3D. The lines are 3D. Now, if we don't have Z coordinates attached, then this would be completely flat and we wouldn't be able to create a topographic topographic surface from it. But because our Z coordinates are attached, we can create a topographic surface. So we want to go into massing and site, select toposurface, create from import, select import instance, and then select your CAD file. And then we want to make sure we know what your X, Y, and Z coordinates are saved in your CAD file. So if you've downloaded it from Equator, they're going to be saved in the contour layer. So just select the layers that have the X, Y, Z coordinates on it and select OK. Okay, so if we zoom in, we can see that our CAD drawing, the contour lines, all have points on them. So these points can be changed if you need to change the elevation of one of the lines, or if you're okay with it, which I'm okay with this surface, all the elevations within this surface, you hit the check mark, the green check mark for finished surface. Okay, and there it is. Let's see, let's hide our CAD file. Okay, this is our surface. Let's see if we can see it in realistic view. And there it is. So we can see all the changes in elevation. And that is how you create a 3D terrain in Revit using a .dwg or AutoCAD file. Thanks for watching.